this duplicitous position while we have a mole problem. Well, it does not look good for you, my friend.
Oh no. Stay thirsty, my friends.
Wake up. You can tell Harley that you led me right to her conspiracy.
When I wake up?
Wake up.
Oh! I fell for that. What the hell? What happened to my bat reflexes?
Rice and shine.
Rice and shine? Where's the rice? And I don't see any shine either. Except maybe on my eye. Old 5:30 PM. Well, I've been out for a while.
Oh, I pity what you're about to face, Wayne.
Oh, do you?
You had so much going for you, Bruce.
Yeah?
But trying to hide your discovery from me... Well...
Well, well.
Harley wanted to spearhead the hunt for the mole. This will be her chance.
Oh,
so,
okay.
Be thoughtful with your words in there. They could be your last.
Thanks for the warning.
Thanks for the warning. I'll be careful.
I hope it's not you, Wayne. But if it is, I'll kill everyone who shows up for your funeral.
Yeah?
What is it now, Bane?
What if Harley shows up for the funeral?
Uncovered.
She looks good without the makeup.
Wayne was right under your nose. And tracked Wayne to the location of the black site. And if he had
sent Wayne to scout it, so lower your damn voice. It was the final piece of the puzzle, and now we got it.
Oh, she's covering for me?
Get your boys ready. We move on the site ASAP. And don't worry your pretty little head about our rat problem. I got it covered. And Bane, tell Freeze to get one of them popsicle makers ready.
She's up to something. She cut totally covered for us.
You're not going anywhere. You're in here. With me.
Is that a good or a bad thing? She's really pretty without the eye diamond things. That guy looked pissed. Oh, yay, feet. Is these a frozen body part?
Thanks for backing me up.
Don't mention it. Can't have him stepping on my turf, you know?
I'm your turf?
I said I'd find the rats. And I will.
Oh, the spa is
your
turf.
Father, he was a hard man, right? Someone lied to him, betrayed him. He ended them. Think he was onto something with that idea? Show no mercy? Take no apologies? That sort of thing?
I can't say killing
wrong. You need to keep your people in line. Sometimes that means making hard choices.
I can't seem too moralistic.
Such a pretty way of saying killing a person.
Yeah.
And taking you for such a ruthless fella.
Trying to
you
fit in around here.
Who I think you are, Bruce.
Who do
Batman?
You think I am?
A man out to prove to the underworld he's just as bad as his dear departed dad. Or there more to the story I should know?
I can't tell you that.
Hidden depths? Secrets you don't want me to see?
I enjoy walks on the beach.
I also enjoy long walks on the beach.
You're funny. Must have gotten that from your mother's side. You know, my dad could be a funny guy, too.
Okay, now what?
And they all fell down to the deep to drown. To
I don't know
the dark to drown.
Okay. Cherry?
He used to sing that to me. My dad. Made me feel safe. Like nothing could hurt me.
You have a nice voice.
You have a nice voice.
Might want to get those ears checked, Brucey.
You get yours checked.
But it's nice to know I have a fan. Been running short of those lately.
Hmm.
In fact, you being like my dad, that's why I got such a soft spot for you.
Oh, you do?
You found me the black site, didn't you?
Father figure
Plus,
thing?
You're not a bad guy. I mean, you're rotten like the rest of us. But... you actually care for some people.
Hmm.
Like that girl. What's her face? Brittany?
Oh, not
no.
Tiffany.
Tiffany. You remember? Early 20s, fresh-faced and optimistic.
I'm not saying anything.
What am I doing? I'd kill to have a friend like that right now.
Sometimes it's good not saying anything.
Friends are great. Except when you have to lose them. Laptop's gone.
What are you?
Yeah, Shaka. We have a turncoat. I've interviewed just about everyone in the place. Except maybe one. Or two. So gosh, that only leaves the two people I haven't cleared.
Me?
You?
And John?
And Catwoman.
Oh, Catwoman.
Maybe it was the guy who Bane gave the hamburger face. But weirdest thing, the laptop went missing after that.
You already cleared me.
Well, you seem to have made up your mind already. Guess one of us has to be the mole. But you've already cleared me.
Trying to make me second guess myself ain't gonna work, sweetie. Nice try, though.
Yeah, thanks.
John, get in here! When I told Puddin I narrowed it down to you two, he begged me to let him interrogate you.
Oh.
I gave him some pointers. Now this is his chance.
Hi, Bruce.
Hi.
Potential rat.
Have at it, John.
Oh. Don't shoot me, John.
Harley, do you mind? Can't learn to ride with training wheels on forever, you know?
I'll be right outside.
He's got the diamonds on his shirt just like she has on her face.
Admit it, you rat scum! You're the...
Oh, damn.
Sorry, I have to make it sound good.
Oh, it's an act. It's okay, I understand.
It's okay, it's okay. You have to keep it up. Right. Thanks.
You're hitting him already. I'll let it play.
I never wanted it to come to this.
Getting complicated.
We both know what has to be done.
What's that?
Catwoman has to take the fall.
Oh.
Think about it, Bruce. Harley's gonna kill that Tiffany girl if it's you. And who knows if she'll stop there.
Abstaining.
Come on, Bruce. You gotta give me something. A little nod. Just nod a little. Just the tiniest bit so I know you're okay with this.
I can't.
Come on, you're killing me.
Can't do that.
Did you even stick up for me?
I really did. I said it loud and clear. Internally. You know Harley. She's not a mind reader.
We'll have to warn Catwoman again then.
Sorry, I'm not as strong as you. Well, I'll get through this, Bruce, but I don't see a lot of options that end too great for you. It's either you or her. What do you want to do, Bruce? She knows it was one of you two. She knows.
It's gotta be another way.
Catwoman. I went to the safe, but it was already gone. And you were right there talking to Harley, so... I know you care about her, but... Yeah.
Alright, time's up!
Perfect, because I'm done!
You got a confession? Great job, Puddin'. Who
he did?
Hanging out to dry?
Go ahead, Bruce. Tell her what you told me.
Oh, God, I can't say Catwoman.
Go ahead, Bruce. It's okay. Just like we talked about.
Letting it run out.
Please. It was Catwoman. Yep, that's what Bruce said.
How do you know?
She took a phone call at Riddler's. Bruce overheard her talking about it.
No, John, no.
I understand, Bruce. I'm disappointed.
I gotta warn her.
So much for the solidarity of sisterhood.
Can I warn her?
And here I was, starting to be a cat person.
I'm a cat
person. I knew you had it in you, John.
I rhyme with cat.
We are gonna do terrible things together.
Huggy.
Like, skin a cat.
No skin a cat. Text Catwoman. We texted her before for the GCPD. Oh, she's right there? What? Oh,
what
crap.
Are you doing?
Did you think I was just gonna let her go or something?
I didn't know she was actually
that
here.
Freaking chance. She's gonna get turned into one of Freeze's popsicles.
Hell nah.
I know cats don't like water, But how do they feel about ice?
Don't.
Please,
I love her.
Please don't hurt her. I love her.
Oh, please.
Oh, please.
Ratting a girl out.
What else could I choose? Everything else was like doing nothing or for it.
This'll just take a second. Get her inside.
Nice. Okay, together now. Oh no. Ow. Ow. Frostbite.
I've seen that look in your eyes before. On other men just before they get themselves killed.
I am. Go Catwoman, go Catwoman! She can't like actually die, right? I'll be so upset. That's
just throw her in one of Riddler's murder boxes. We have a black site to raid.
Oh, crap.
Come on, Bruce. Time to raise some hell.
John, get her out. No! I forget, what is it, fire that comes out of that thing? Or in that thing? Oh crap, that's it. I gotta wait till next episode. We all gotta wait till next episode. Crap! 89% of players left Gordon feeling remorseful. He was annoyed when Catwoman evaded him and the GCPD. He was frustrated when you tried to resist arrest. Because of what you said after Waller fired him, he feels a little remorseful about trying to arrest you. Well, that's good. Annoyed and frustrated, but then he feels bad about it. Most people have that effect on him. 25% of players did something that will make Waller aligned with you. She felt miffed when you didn't accept her apology about the convoy. Oh, I just chose another thing. She felt superior when you pushed back against her desire to use the villains in the Black Site raid. She will be proud of you for keeping your cover, even when the stakes are high. Hmm. Okay, most people did not achieve this, though. Only one quarter able to do. 88% of players left Tiffany feeling honored. She felt valued when you took the time to let her apologize and explain her actions. She felt honored that you would let her in on your Batman secret. I want her to become the next big tech person. That'd be freaking awesome. She is cool. I like her. Huh. Not many people achieve this. 25% of players left Harley feeling less skeptical of you. She was unconvinced by your defense that you weren't the mole. She felt justified when you told her you agreed. Sometimes people needed to be dealt with. She felt less skeptical of you when you ratted out Catwoman as the mole. I did not. I sat there and did nothing. I literally said nothing. I guess the only way to not rat her out is to say it was me. What would have happened then? Jeez. She felt justified when you told her you agreed that some people need to be dealt with. Sheesh. Well, she was unconvinced, but she's convinced now, I guess. Again, minority. 25% of players left John feeling valued by you. He took to heart your advice to manipulate others. He looks so funny, actually. Like, aw, shucks. He felt sorry for letting down his hero when he couldn't retrieve the laptop. He felt appreciated as a best friend when you decided to out Catwoman together. I didn't. I said nothing. I sat there and did nothing. Oh, well. Oh, I'm sorry, Selina. Crap. 24% of players left Selina feeling betrayed. She was grateful that you warned her and helped her evade the GCPD. She felt honored that you let her see your Batcave. Because you gave her up to Harley, she feels betrayed. I did no such thing. I tried to stop them, too. The only thing I could say was that I loved her. I knew it wouldn't make a difference. But what was I supposed to do? Did you warn Catwoman that GCPD was coming after her? 58% of players warned Catwoman. She avoided the GCPD and stole Harley's laptop before John. What dating advice did you give John in the cafe to help him attract Harley's attentions? 46% of players told John to manipulate Harley and he gave you an inkblot test. That's funny. Did you tell Tiffany you're a Batman? 87.5% of players told Tiffany your secret. I almost didn't, too. But I was like, wait, she could be the new Lucius. Did you out yourself as the mole or put the blame on Catwoman? 23.7% of players let John throw Catwoman under the bus. She's now in mortal danger. Crap. I didn't say anything. It's a telltale. Even when you don't say things, you end up saying something. Because I rarely see it. I always, almost always say things. And that's stuff. No thank you. Dun dun dun. Dun dun dun. Dun dun dun. Yes, updating content. What, did I lose internet or something? I'm actually looking at my modem, it looks fine. Let's see extras, we get to walk around and look at the codex again, I think. Return to the Bat Cave. Let's see if there's anything new from this episode. Not looking at anything else, I'm just gonna... Oh, I can't turn the record player on. Handprint recognized. See if there's any new stories. I remember this. I wish there was a quick way to go down. Anything new. Seemed like the newer stuff was on the bottom before. Yeah, he's even less now. He's completely fired off the force, I think, right? He's not doing anything. Where was Batman? Hot potato, hot potato, da-da-da-da-da. This is new. Exclusive Riddler body stolen from Agency Convoy by Julia Martins. The Gazette can now confirm that the Riddler's body has been taken from Agency custody and that it was the target of the mass convoy's attack last night. They really need to proofread this stuff. What's going on with the Gazette, man? They have no proofreaders. When asked why the agency was in possession of the Riddler's corpse, Henry Chang, an agency spokesman, said, "We don't know where these leaks are coming from, but whoever they are, they do not speak for the agency or the Gotham City Police Department. Anything they say should be regarded as unreliable." Chang refused to comment further. Speculations were raised in regards to the agency's credibility when the Gazette published an article calling into question the validity of one of their earlier statements. It was first erroneously claimed by the agency that they're responsible for capturing Riddler, resulting somehow in the man's death. With the agency moving Riddler's body to an undisclosed location, it's speculated that the government group might have been trying to take the corpse out of the hands of local authorities. This would prevent access to key evidence and set back an attempt to properly investigate Riddler's death. All right, I thought this was meant stolen. The outcry and hostility from Gotham citizens against the agency has increased as falsehoods are increasingly brought to light. Agency Director Amanda Waller was unavailable for an interview at this time. GCPD and agency spotted at Wayne Tower. And I don't know if this is new, actually. I don't think the other thing's new either. I thought they were talking about that it was stolen. Riddler's body. Alright, so let's check out Codex. Okay, we have a few exclamation marks. And looks like maybe a few new things about Sanctus. Cool. Alright, so. Gordon has been fired from his position at the GCPD because he couldn't let well enough alone. He came after me because he had suspicions that I was somehow involved with the Pact and has no idea how right he is. Just not the way he thinks. When Waller discovered he was trying to take me into custody, she came down on him hard. I wish it hadn't come to this. Jim's a good man and a damn good cop. He doesn't deserve to be kicked off the force for doing his job. He will be reinstated. Mark my words. And I didn't want to do that. I was trying to move down. John Doe. Alright, so it's got quite a bit of new stuff here. While undercover, John has been the closest thing I've had to a friend within Riddler's Pact. He's looked out for me, and even stood up to Harley on my behalf. Despite that, there's a darkness to him that he seems unable to control. When we were confronted by Detective Bullock just outside the Riddler's warehouse, John didn't think twice about trying to kill him. And he nearly did. Thankfully, the detective survived, but I blame myself for allowing it to happen. Okay, good. I was wondering he would have died from blunt force trauma. John tried hard to get me to confess to Harley that Selena stole the laptop, thinking it was the best way to keep me safe, and I really do appreciate his genuine concern for me. So I took his advice and blamed Selena. I did not. I said nothing. Jeez. I knew it would put her in danger, but John was right. I need to keep my head above water in order to stay in this Pack long enough to put an end to their scheming, and I can't do that if I confess to having betrayed them. I just hope that John will continue to have my back. Well, I gotta help Selena. Damn it. Not liking the way that went out. Went down. Alfred continues to encourage me to accept allies, but I can see the strain our work places on him. I was worried that he was beginning to fracture under the weight of our work, but he came through with a useful new upgrade for my contacts. He's always been good with technology, and I'm happy he stepped up to help now that Lucius is gone. I don't know what I'd do without Alfred. I hope I haven't messed up things with Catwoman for good, like killed her or alienated her or anything like that. Gotta find a way to make her understand. Tiffany Fox. Tiffany tried to have me arrested. I should have seen that coming. I've been acting evasive and suspicious, and I hardly left her much of a choice. So I revealed my most closely guarded secret and brought her into the fold. I told her I'm Batman. I don't know if it was the right move. I mean, either. I don't know if this will keep her safe or put her farther in harm's way, but it felt right, and that's all I can hope for in situations like these. You know, the more people know that he's Batman, the more it can be, like, tortured out of them or something. Not a good thing. Waller went too far today when she fired Gordon. I understand her motivation. She's trying to keep me in the Pact in order to stop their plan to obtain Project Lotus and use it to some dastardly ends, but that doesn't make it right. Gordon was another casualty in her merciless mission. I began to realize that whatever the cost isn't just an expression to her, it's a personal motto. I guess I hit this and I go down and then I hit the previous menu thing. It's annoying. I wish I could mouse wheel it like in the with the Gazette entries. For some reason it doesn't work like that. Need to be more consistent, Telltale. Turns out Selena and Riddler worked together in the past. She's in town to break up his pact and rain down a little revenge on them for killing him. Her first step in this plan apparently was stealing the decryptor for Riddler's laptop right out from under my nose. The second part, to steal the laptop itself right out from under Harley's nose. Her plans, however, fell through when they landed her in the hot seat, along with me as one of the potential pact moles. In order to maintain my cover, I had to cast a blame onto her, or just not saying anything. I thought she'd be able to handle herself against the Pact. It was a small risk, especially with how much is on the line should I be found out. She may not forgive me, but there are innocent lives at stake. That, at least, she has to understand. Hope so. Harley? Harley has taken over as the de facto leader of Riddler's Pact. While she runs the gang with an iron fist, she's still not as brutal as Bane and Freeze have proven to be, which is some comfort at least. After discovering the decryptor in Riddler's old workshop, I knew that my only option was to steal his laptop from Harley in order to decode the information on it before the Pact could learn its contents. The theft of the laptop, however, led to renewed interest in finding the alleged mole in their midst and landed myself and Selina at the center of Harley's investigation. Quote unquote. Unfortunately, I had to pass the blame onto Selina. I did not. In order to maintain my cover, staying one step ahead of the Pact and stopping them is my mission, no matter the cost. The gambit worked, for now, though it's only a matter of time before I'm found out for good. Hopefully, I'll have stopped the Pact before it gets to that point. Bane? Bane returned with the group from the agency convoy, but since it was his plan that had gone awry, his reputation within the Pact was tarnished. Harley solidified herself as the leader of the gang while Bane stewed in shadows. Bane hurt his position further when he murdered one of his own subordinates in an attempt to find the mole. Timothy's guilt wasn't certain, but Bane ended him anyway. Bane found me in the alley outside of Bodhi's spa. Turns out he had been spying on me. He knocked me out and unceremoniously dragged me back to stand judgment in front of Harley. Still like the other Bane better on this dude. I don't remember reading about him, so Detective Harvey Bullock has worked alongside Commissioner Gordon for years, but his attitude has kept him from rising in the ranks. Still, he's one of the few good cops still in Gotham. Now he has like a broken skull. Not a broken skull. He's got a big headache. I crossed paths with Harvey Bullock when Catwoman, John, and I were infiltrating the Riddler's old workshop. Couldn't tell if he was there to guard the spot or was in the wrong place at the wrong time. John was ready to knock him out with a crowbar, and I had to make a quick decision of how to handle the situation between injuring Bullock or corrupting him. Oh, really? I could have corrupted him? I'm kind of glad I didn't, if he's one of the few good cops left in Gotham. Even less good cops. Yeah. This is from episode 1. It seems like so long ago since episode 1. Gordon and I found where Riddler sleeps. He set up a hideout in an old water tower on the edge of Gotham's east end. Walking around that place was like taking a tour of Riddler's twisted psychology. He's methodical and obsessive in his sadism, using agents as guinea pigs to test out prototypes of his murder boxes. Designed to be in a giant escape room, Gordon and I almost didn't get out of there alive. Luckily, Gordon was instrumental in solving his riddle, and we managed to escape together. I guess two heads really are better than one. Selina, John, and I went back to Riddler's workshop in the hopes of finding a way to decrypt his laptop. We barely survived a run-in with one of the Riddler's old puzzles, and Selina and I went deeper into the workshop. We were able to recover the decryptor device, but Selina had her own plans for it, and she handcuffed me to a chair in order to take it for herself. And then she gave it back to me. Well, I took it back, actually. She gave me the laptop, and I took the thing back. Boop, boop, boop. Nothing there. Okay, Sanctus. From what I've able to piece together is an secure ancillary technology support. Cool! That's what it means. I like that. From what I've been able to piece together is an unauthorized offshoot of the agency that developed the deadly supervirus and biochemical weapon known as Project Lotus. Yeah, that's support, huh? That's funny meaning of the word support. Sanctus used to be a science division of the shadowy government group until Amanda Waller took over, discovered their unethical methods, and shut them down. However, they seem to have regrouped and continued their research in secret and out of the hands of the law. And Bodhi Spa. A massage parlor by all appearances, Bodhi Spa is actually a front for Sanctus, an illegal offshoot of the agency. According to what I uncovered from Riddler's encrypted laptop, this is the same location where Project Lotus, a deadly virus and biochemical weapon, was developed and tested on human subjects. This is sure to be the site the Pact will raid. While it may house scientists lacking a moral code beneath its foundation, above ground it is frequented by innocent clients. You sure there isn't? And messieurs. If I don't stop them, the pact is liable to kill everyone they find within, regardless of who's guilty and who's innocent. Well, guys, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode 4, whenever that comes out. And always seek adventure.